Tonespace is a plugin for MIDI sequencer software. It's a chord generator and visualizer. You can find a chord just with one click. You can even play a chord just by hitting one single note on your MIDI keyboard. Check out description for website address for downloading the plugin. Now let's start the installation of the plugin by double-clicking on the DMG file you just downloaded. In Finder, choose Go from the menu bar and select Library while pressing Option K. What we want to do here is to put one file into a library audio plugins components folder. That's where user audio units plugins are installed. Drag and drop tonespace.component file into the component folder. The icon of a file looks like a Lego block. Finally, drag and drop tonespace.app file into the application folder. That's it for application and plugin installation. Open Audio MIDI Setup. You might have to press Command and 2 to show the MIDI Studio window. Double click on ISC driver icon. Make sure Device is Online checkbox is ticked. Now you can close Audio MIDI Setup application. Open Logic Pro X. We are now going to try Tonespace. On Logic Pro X, we need to add two tracks, one for Tonespace plugin and another for instrument. Open new document and make a new software instrument track. Choose Tonespace plugin. Now we are going to add another software instrument track. You can choose any instrument you want. I decided to choose piano for this. And now we have to set up MIDI environment. Open MIDI environment from window menu. Here are all the tracks we have added. What we want to do here is to connect between the instrumental track and Tonespace track. Move the mouse cursor to the right edge of the track. Click and hold right on the small triangle icon. Drag right to the next one. And release the mouse button. Now these tracks are connected. In this final chapter, I'm going to show you how to configure Tonespace. First, we're going to set up MIDI-In, MIDI-Out, then Trigger. You can select a MIDI input device by configuring MIDI-In. MIDI-Out configuration allows you to choose where Tonespace sends signals to. Finally, with a trigger configuration, you can choose how you can interact with Tonespace. First of all, let's start setting up MIDI input device. Here is a small reminder. Musical typing doesn't seem to be supported, so you have to use MIDI input devices. Bring up Tonespace window. Click on MIDI-In pull-down menu. MIDI-In settings dialog is opened. Tick checkboxes of MIDI devices you want to activate for MIDI inputs. Go back to the MIDI-In pull-down menu. Choose the MIDI device you want to use for MIDI-In. Now we are setting up MIDI-Out. Click on the MIDI-Out pull-down menu. Choose configure. You again see MIDI settings of dialog. Click on ISC driver bus 1. Click on MIDI out pull-down menu again and choose ISC driver bus 1. We are finally setting up trigger. Choosing MIDI triggers note from the trigger pull-down menu allows you to use MIDI input devices. With mouse click trigger cell, you can use that user interface in the main window to trigger sound. In summary, make sure to enable your MIDI input device for the active MIDI inputs in the MIDI settings dialog, which can be accessed from either MIDI-In or MIDI-Out pull-down menu. ISC driver bus 1 also needs to be activated for the active MIDI outputs. If you want to use your MIDI keyboard, make sure that trigger is set to MIDI triggers not. MIDI-In is set to a MIDI input device. MIDI-Out is set to ISC driver bus 1. If you want to use your mouse to play sound, make sure that trigger is set to mouse click trigger cell. On click, it's set to trigger cell. MIDI out is set to ISC driver bus 1. Thank you for watching.